Hello there, welcome! Let's see how to personalize text and how to get it in 3D. Leave comments to improve our videos. Let's suppose to type a long curve. This path can be made with a polygon or a freehand tool. It doesn't matter. Select it first and then go to text and then to fit text to path. Click on the path where you want to start typing and then you can go on. You can edit this text in size and font with the text tool. Make sure of what you select before editing. If you select the path, you will edit it and the text follows. If you select the text and scale, you will scale not the path inside, but the text sides. On top you can choose different kinds of text on the path. While you use the pick tool, drag the red rhombus to change the starting point. Remember that this text will always follow the path. So, if the path changes shape, the text follows. You can also edit the text using the shape tool. Click on the text and white small nodes appear on it. Each of them represents the position of each letter. Drag them to change the distance as you like. To delete text, simply enable the text tool and remove it all. You can also personalize and edit text, converting it to a vector curve. Just select it, go to Object, and then to Convert to Curves. You will see from the Object Manager that the text will be converted to a curve, so you can edit its shape with the Shape tool or add effects. The text becomes fully customizable. Let's see how to get 3D text. To do this, you need to use the Extrude tool inside the Effects, more at the bottom of the list. However, this works on vectors only, so you must convert the text into a vector first, and then you can go on with the Extrude tool. Just click and drag. Drag the black cross to change the extrusion direction, and the small rectangle to change the extrusion length. The extrusion will have the same color of the object filling. Decide contour color and filling color from the object properties panel. Even if you added extrusion, the object will always remain a curve, according to the software. The 3D text is seen as a 2D text curve with the extrude tool on it. So, when you apply any gradient or pattern through the object properties, these are applied normally, without distinguishing any extrusion. To respect the extrusion effect, you must edit using the Extrude tool options on top, that do appear when the tool is enabled. You can use the icons more on the right. The first one sets the extrusion filling. By default, it is equal to the object filling, but you can apply a different solid color or even a gradient. Use the lens button to adjust lightness, for example the kind of source or its position. Always check your workspace for a direct preview. The extrusion will always follow the shape of the text. If the text is changed, the extrusion follows. You can always come back to the original 2D text clicking on the red icon. This undoes the extrude tool applied. Thanks for watching this video. Check the next ones to discover more about CorelDRAW X7.